It's Mark, and it's for me, it's Friday night here in Plymouth, Massachusetts. And I have no idea why I'm going to try to play anything right now, because I've already had my meal out at my favorite restaurant, a couple martinis. Came back, had a great apple pie from Centerville Pie Company in Centerville, Mass, on the Cape. And, don't tell me I screwed that up. Oops, new match. And, Wingfoot West, so that's a mistake. I haven't retried this. Wingfoot West evidently needed to have something done to it, because it literally shut me down every single time. So, and I had everything all set just now, and I made the mistake of just going out of it. So we're going to put Brookline back in. And that should be fast. I mean, let's face it, how many Brooklines can there be, right? Correct. So the LiDAR course, 2022. Now, my problem is, I don't know which is the most recent. Is it the one on the right, or is it the one on the left? I'm going on the one with the left. And I already had all my settings all set, but obviously I lost that when I exited out. We can make this fast, and we're going to make this wind speed medium, and knowing what I do about my state and when the winds come from other times of the year, not right now. Actually, even right now, northwest would be right. Sometimes northeast. We don't want northeast, that's for sure. And we'll make the fairway moderate. We're going to make the green way, the green firm. We're going to make the green speed moderate. Do you really want to do that? We'll see. And the timer day will be morning. And it'll be like clouds. And we'll begin the round. Yeah, so it's going to be kind of interesting, because I am not playing 2K21 off of my... even though I'm using a PS5, if you haven't heard this before, I'm actually playing it off my PS4. And I have both of them connected to my account. So the PS5 actually can play software off the PS4. I never got the upgrade version of the 2K21, 2K23 course. I'm sorry. And so I'm playing 2K23 from my PS4. And most likely when I go start playing EA as well, even though I love to play both, I will not pay for another, another version of this to play on the PS5, because... really, I don't want to spend the money, number one. And number two, my thumbs aren't going to be able to take playing two different golf games, especially when I'm trying to learn one golf game. Whether or not I come back to 2K23, I don't know. But by mid-June, once the season ends with my society, I'm planning on selling my PS4. Once again, it's really for the money, because I'm taking a vacation that's going to eat up a lot of money. I haven't had a vacation since spring of 2019, and I'm treating myself to another one if physically I can do it. So we'll see. Come on, Kerwa. Oh, okay, that's decent. Wow, I thought I'd get a little bit more than that.
Here's what you're dealing with for a birdie. Looking very nice.
Go in. Oh, wow.
There's almost nothing
left. Thought I had that one.
First hole, you're at even par. Good to see.
This is the 2022 course, so it's being brought over from 2K21. And so I have no idea if anything's been done to it to adjust it, but it looks like since this the same course has got two versions up there when you go in, I'm pretty certain that, yeah, it's had something done to it. That's a hook. That, I didn't think it would do it. It did. Not even bothering looking at my... Now, again, what I'm going to like about EA is that, as in Lynx, you get your results after the shot. Here, in 2K, they give you the results during the shot, so that when you go to look at it after the shot, there's nothing there. It's gone. Now, I don't know if there's something else I'm missing out on, like I'm supposed to be able to keep that or something. I have no idea. Ooh. Went a little further than I wanted.
Par save, possibly. It's getting there.
There we go. I got my red shirt. I can buy any kind of clothing I want. I can buy any clubs I want. Right now, I've got so much dang game money, it's ridiculous. I'm playing Career again, too, besides. And Career gives you so much. It's like, hilarious. In fact, right now, I've got to go ahead and turn in more of my fittings, because it's really bad. I just have way too much. I just make so much money turning in fittings. I'll turn in fittings. People go, you should use them. It's like, why? They're not fittings I need. They give me fittings for hybrids, for instance. I'm not using a hybrid. Why would I keep them? And I get rid of them. They're all extra. And I could turn in fittings, and usually every time I turn them in, I get at least 300 game money plus. Especially if I get a lot of red, purple, blue type things. The grays and stuff, forget it. That's a joke. Could be on the heavy rough, huh? Okay. Get up there. Okay. Not what I wanted, per se, but I'm pretty happy. Ooh. Nasty. Like the red shirt. Just got it. I think I have blue pants. I can't tell. And they don't tell you in the description that they are. I went there. I went to look. I'm looking at the different colors. I'm trying to guess which color is what versus black and navy are so hard to figure out anyways. But, oh, that's not good.
Well, that's too bad. Okay, second shot here on the four.
I'm trying to do things that evidently you just can't do in the game. What can I tell you? I like it, but it's not going to get the distance. Yeah, it died.
Okay, here's our third shot.
I wish this was a par five. I'd be pretty thrilled right now. Come on, Dad.
Okay, yeah. Nice chip.
Pretty happy with that. Yeah, the Country Club book line. That kind of screwed things up for EA, because they had this whole big plan to come out a year earlier than they did. Okay, so they had lined up everything for all the events that were happening, last year and not this year. So now they got courses that aren't being used for big events. So I thought it was kind of funny myself. It's like, okay, so you had a lot to do and you just didn't realize it because you're dealing with Augusta and the Royal Society.
Oh my, you caught that one. Look at it.
And those people just want things to be right. I've been saying that right along. Plus, there were changes made to some of the, I'm not surprised at some of the delays. I'm surprised it took them that long to figure it out that they needed to make the changes. I think they decided, now we can get away with not doing it. And then someone probably said, no, you can't. Because some course changes, some changes to some of the courses that were made over the past year or two. And where are we going? Go in. Oh, wow. Hooked too soon. Wow, I thought I'd have that one.
This one's 8 feet away. Looking good.
Yeah. So, yeah, There was a lot of good courses. I mean, there was courses that did have some changes made to them. But obviously there was an issue over letting it go and not letting it go, I'm guessing. I wish there was more backstory to things that happen in gaming in terms of what really happened. But and a lot of people are poo-pooing EA already without having played it or knowing anything about it. Just as so many people justify 2K's game, we'll call it HB's game, when the there's so many issues in that game. You know, the basic part of the game is good. You know, it really is. I love it. But there are issues where the wind, and first of all, why'd they make the wind meter smaller? They needed to make it bigger. They need to make a wind meter where you can actually see it. I'm sitting here 8 feet from my TV. The gray level is almost non-existent because it's covered by the 8 mile per hour wind or whatever. And when you go to no numbers, all you have is the wind meter itself. That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen. It really is. It's like, come on, people. And you need to have, if you're going to have variable wind, I need to see that gray moving up and down. It needs to be highly visible for me to see it, even 8 feet away. So, you know, I don't get it. They did things in 2K23 that, you know, I'm still trying to figure out why people liked it so much. Everybody got 2K23, nice. And they didn't like all the different kinds of balls you're using. They didn't like what happened in society. They didn't like the fittings. They didn't like this. They didn't like that. And basically, they all wanted 2K21 all over again with a few fixes. And it's like, well, that's kind of embarrassing for HB or 2K23, whoever made the decision to come out with what they did come out with. The society people definitely didn't want all the crap. They just wanted to be able to play. Oh, guess what? They deleted that too. You don't have the ability to play with more than one person on Society Play. So you have all that, and then match play, in no offense, is still the stupidest thing I've ever seen. How do you go ahead and call something pro using a pro swing, and then you give basic bullshit for the beginner golfer to play? I don't get it. I really don't. It's like basic and pro mixed together, and it doesn't make any sense to me. So anyway, just my opinion, because I've been playing this since January of 2019, and I don't get it. Needless to say, the things that they need to make better are the things that people like the game for. And it doesn't take much to do that, I don't think. They just don't want to spend the money on programming and making societies work, because that's what people want. The people who don't want societies, get the hell out. Go play EA. And the designer, the course designer needs some fixing too, as most course designers will tell you. And they're the ones who have the right to say it. I don't. I'm just telling you what I'm hearing from them. Anyway. So that's not going to make a shit on up a club. Oh, well.
This is what our third shot's looking like.
This course, I really don't have any problems with this course because, unless I find something where it's sitting the red. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my. The chip goes down, and that's
nice. So, anyway, yeah, I know I'm very gabby tonight. What can I say? I'm just saying that EA has a good game that needs, that they need to work on this, what's considered their strengths by the people who play the game. That you got to listen to them because they're the ones who are paying and are going to stay regardless of EA. You have designer and societies fixed. You do better with those because, believe me, if you need to know what those fixes need to be, hit me up. I'll let you know. But in all honesty, EA is going to have its own people and its own detractors. Evidently, it goes on and on. I'm not all familiar with that. I'm an old Lynx player, so I can go ahead and detract both of them, I guess. That's, you know, and people can say what they want about Lynx, but you've got to be my age, I guess, to really know much about it. Because if you're at least 20 years younger than me, you don't know shit about Lynx. Seriously. And you were just lucky to play it if you ever did. And people will talk about, well, Tiger Woods, blah, blah, blah. I don't know about that. I know I started playing Lynx in the 90s on computer, and I loved it. Absolutely loved that. I was addicted to that one. Oh, my God. I couldn't wait. I had a road job. I couldn't wait to get home to play that. Get in an online tournament, too. I played it a lot.
No, that's going right by the hole, isn't it? This one's just a 3-foot putt.
I would pre-play a course before a tournament. I'd go ahead and place balls. What the thing is that you could practice. You could have mulligans. You could put yourself anywhere out on a course to practice, basically. And that's what I would do. I would go practice. Practice, practice, practice. I don't want to do that, do I? Yeah, I like that.
Good job. And this one's about 190 or
yeah, it was fun. You could practice on any course, move your ball around, determine what types of shots you wanted to take, and go do it. You didn't have to have a specific practice area to go to. That's nonsense. You know, you want to practice your swing? Go practice out on a course. The putting area, practice putting thing is so ridiculous in EA. I mean, not in EA, in 2K. That, and that was HB. It's like, guys, do you ever play this game? Do you really understand it? That's nice, I think. Well, it was nice. Come back. Come back.
Well done.
Nope.
500 to sink this putt.
All right, ooh, I don't think I can get that one. Oh, no. Okay.
On this hole, we've got this.
Anyway,
this one's tracking.
My goal would probably be to play, would have been to play both. I mean, if I was younger and I had good thumbs, I would say I'd really like to play both games. And my brain could probably handle it, but I don't think my brain can handle two different golf games, which might have two different types of strokes. Yeah, so that's... So you're giving me a pitch shot. I didn't want a pitch shot. All right. See how far... that's looking pretty darn good, isn't it? Wow.
Oh, yeah, that's going to be just fine. Great work. Amazing.
All right.
And after that one, you're bringing your score.
Well, I mean, I've got myself easy settings here, kind of, sort of. You know, firm, I think it's like firm and, what do I have it at? Firm but moderate green, so... that's kind of easy settings here for Brookline.
Yeah, that was a good swing. Well done.
Figured I might as well try it out because some people may want to use this. It's something I may want to use actually later in the spring in my schedule. Because I'm going to keep trying to maintain a schedule. I will be probably, barring anything going wrong, I'll probably be on vacation May 8th to the 18th.
Going in the wrong direction, I think.
And I will not have access to the game off my PlayStation.
Yeah, we're in the green side rough currently. Let's be careful with that chip.
Oh, no. I thought that was going in. Oh, my God.
Close. Well done.
Boo. Boo.
This one.
I was kind of hoping for the Tiger Woods red shirt. Was I supposed to win that somehow, or was it someplace I missed it? All I know is that the clothing offered is horrendous. It should be so much better than what it is. They don't want to sell you hats. They don't want to sell you... All they want to do is sell you visor hats. That's it. So many of the good clothing accessories that they had in 2K21 are gone. They don't exist in 2K23. And it takes forever for them to offer anything decent in their... in there, whatever.
This one's heading for the green.
You know, I chose what they gave me just then, and because I thought, wow, that's right.
For a 9-foot putt here. Nice putt. That's your fourth birdie of the day.
I'm pretty happy with how I'm playing. I mean, I'm not on fire here, but considering the fact I'm talking and just moving right along, I'm not doing much planning at all. This is really me playing a round of lightning golf. I mean, that's kind of what I like to do sometimes. There's another course I want to try tonight as well anyway, so. No, that's going to be bad.
Yeah, this one's going to get rough.
Yeah. Snap that shot a little bit instead of keeping that swing even.
This one's your third.
Okay. You see, I really do know when I do something wrong. Ooh. How about that? Come on, wind, blow it.
This one's a little too right on approach.
You get nothing. You get nothing and like it. Oh, another just missed that.
Nice to save par on this one. Looking pretty good. All right, well done.
Moving right along. I'm probably playing this 18 holes in the amount of time I normally would take to play nine. This is blast right through here. I love this course. The person who did this did a nice job. I'm not so certain. I don't know about the accuracy. I can tell you that the pars and the distances are pretty darn good. The look of the course, can't really comment on that.
I'm okay with that.
I actually... have gone to Brookline for medical reasons. Brookline is just outside Boston. Uh-oh. And,
all right, let's see how this next hole is playing.
I have had to go there for some appointments.
Good luck. Par three. Oh, effortlessly done. Nice swing.
Yeah, but where's it going to end up? I like that. I wish I'd been over a little bit more, can you imagine? That would have been on the hole if I'd been over a little bit more to the left. Oh. Too hard. I knew as soon as he hit that ball, that was too hard. I didn't want to hit it that hard. That time I did, but that didn't go where I wanted. So this happens to me every round where I have holes that I can't judge. See, I go through this all the time. I just can't judge the speed in the break. So, and when there's moving shade, forget it. That's like, I don't know. It literally bothers me a lot when you have the moving shade like that. Because, as I've said a million times before, playing this game with shade is not the same as in real life when there's shade. It's just not even close. It's not even close. Nice. Wait, some guy's wearing my shirt over there. No. Boy, I thought I had that one pretty easy.
And just drop this on in and you'll get a pop.
Wow. I mean, I think in real life, I could see my breaks, even if I missed the putt. I think it would be a lot closer than what I have going on here. You just can't see the breaks, at least not on my TV. I have a Samsung TV, which has great picture. I love my picture on it. But I don't know. I was going to get a Sony made specifically, which is really was considered tops for gaming. I hit fast intentional. Let's see if it does anything. Oh, yeah. So I kind of cut back on that shot, but actually then hit it fast because that's what I want. So, yeah, there we go. That's a fast round at the Country Club in Brookline 2022 U.S. Open. Everything looks good. The scorecard. Let's see. Can you pull this thing, move it? Yeah. So, basically, the pars for this were good, and the distances were good, and nobody wants to look at a scorecard with a double bogey on, do they? No. So I'd say give this a go, and other people can rate it whatever they want. I am going to rate it a 5. I'm sure somebody else will rate it a 1 if they play bad. And off we go. And we'll check you later, because I'm going to be hitting up another course soon.